Hello, hello, thanks for tuning in. Okay, today we're going to take a look at the Renogy battery monitor. This is the 500 amp one, RBM500, it's Renogy battery monitor, 500 amp, obviously made in China. There's the address, there's the key features there, 10 volts to 120 volts up to 500 amps. Can display voltage, current, consume power, battery capacity, all that good stuff. Right inside the box, we got an instruction manual. We have the control unit itself. It's pretty thin. There's the specs. Seems like we got a little power cord here for the shunt. This is the actual shunt itself. And this thing is substantial, guys. This thing weighs, it's pretty hefty. Excuse me. So there's where the red wire would go in from the battery positive. That's your battery negative. And your load side negative. It's very important which way you put this thing because you can put it in reverse. It comes with a nice little holder here. 500 amps. And you can see down there, it is calibrated. I believe they shave some of the metal off them rods to get that 500 amp reading and to figure out how much can go through here because this is a pretty good chunk of steel or whatever it is. You got your data cable, 6 meters, shielded. And your mounting screws for the shunt. We decided we're not going to use the mounting screws for the shunt. We're just gonna go ahead and take it apart and just use it without it. Okay, we have the shunt off. And as you can see, the machining is very good on it. It's nice, got a little circuit board there. It's protected with epoxy. Looks like that's lasered in. Yeah, so that's about it. Now, in order to connect this thing to the battery, which is gonna be your B minus side there, you're gonna have to use some type of wire gauge. Now, if you're pulling 500 amps through this off your system, the wire is gonna be phenomenal. So you're gonna wanna use like a bus bar. So we didn't have one, but we went ahead and just made one. Took a piece of copper, folded it over. With our application here, we pull maybe 30 to 40 amps, not too much. So we're gonna go ahead and just use this. This can handle probably 60, 70 amps, this little bus bar. So just get yours according to size. So we're gonna get this thing together and get it on the battery and see how it looks. Okay, we got the bus bar on the shunt. As you see, it's bent to step down and clear the bolt here. So we have it all hooked up. We put the B positive in there. It doesn't matter which side you put it on. And it is a tiny screwdriver, flat tip. So now we're gonna mount this to the battery, mount all the negative feeds to this, hook up the power side, and then we'll come to the screen and get it plugged in and see what happens. Okay, as you can see there, we have the bus bar standoff, the shunt, all of the negatives hooked, and the one positive wire going over there. So now we'll take a look at the control panel and we'll start turning some loads on. Okay, we have the 200 amp hour battery hooked up. We'll go through all the features real quick. So if you want to turn it on, just click any button. As you can see there, for some reason it says we're charging, but the solar panels are off, so who knows. If you hold this arrow button over, it'll bring up the light module, so you can turn it off, or you can set the brightness, and then just push okay, and you'll come back out there. Again, this, we'll control the brightness, this here, you hold it, and that turns it off. If you hold down the OK button, it'll bring you into here. This is where you'll set up your amp hours and everything. So you just hit OK and just go over and set all your stuff. And then hit the double arrow back and you'll come out. So our full voltage is 13.8 per the book. 9.5 is the zero. Power off at 10.8 on the BMS. We set our alarm for 75 amp hours. So we'll go back. And now we'll turn on some loads and see what happens. It says we're charging, which, again, could be picking up some light outside. Let's see what happens. All right, we turn the charge controller on. So now we'll see what's happening. Looks like it's taking some power, about 0.01 amps. And we'll flip on the solar panels now to see if we get anything. All right, we flipped on the solar panels and we don't have anything. Or maybe we do, in and out. Just fractions. We're gonna go ahead and turn on the inverter now and see what the draw is on the inverter. It's a 3000 watt Renogy inverter. And it's just sitting there at idle. So we're taking about 10 watts, 0.7 amps out, so a little less than an amp. All right, let's go ahead and put a little load on it and see what happens. We'll put a small refrigerator on it. We put a small load on it, a little dorm size refrigerator. So we're pulling down about 5-6 amps. And then we're gonna go ahead and plug in a huge deep freezer here and see what that pulls. We turned on the deep freezer now. And we'll go compare it with an amp gauge that we have. So it's pulling about 11.4 amps. So that's about right. It's about spot on. All right, so that's really it. Super simple install. Really the only thing you have to have is some type of connection from the battery to the shunt. And if you're gonna be pulling high amperage, then you should probably be using a bus bar. As you can see, we're only drawing down 12 amps total through the whole system. So all is good, that bus bar can handle it, that we made no problem. So yeah, the final install, we'll be mounting it in a wall wherever you want to mount it. So this is a good little indicator. It's showing basically 199 amp hours out of the 200, it's going down 100%. We can run 16 hours if we stay like this. It's drawing 165 watts, drawing 12.2 amps at 13.5 volts. So it's good little information. We'll see how it holds up and see if it holds true. We hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.